bedroom stoves here, folks. So I've got in my hand here the Blacksmith Camping Supplies Australian Made Firewood Carrier. Now, this was designed first and foremost to help you collect and carry firewood from around the campsite, but it's armed with handles, a sling, and eyelets in the corners that give it 101 other uses around the campsite. And as with all Blacksmith camping products, they've made this guy really tough. They've used a military grade 505 GSM Dynaproofed and rotproof canvas in this. It's just a single sling of canvas, so there's not much to break, it's nice and tough. It's bound together around the edges with a nylon binding, and there's high quality Australian made. Once again, the canvas is Australian made, the webbing is Australian made, so 50 mil webbing, and this runs right around the bottom of the sling here to give it lots of strength, so there's no break in the webbing there, so the weight's distributed all throughout. And there are stainless steel eyelets in the corners here, which can act as peg points, tie points, or all sorts, which we'll go into shortly. Now, just a little bit on the handles here. There is two different handle types on here. Now, we'll start with these outer shorter handles here. Now, these form part of this continuous thing that go right around the bottom here. So these are the strongest handles on the wood carrier here. They've also added these sling handles in here, which are just stitched in underneath this handle here. So these are still really tough. It's still really strong stitching and put together well, but if you're carrying really heavy weights, maybe rely on these handles first and foremost. But what these longer handles do is two uses. Firstly, to be able to throw this over your shoulder as a sling to carry it. But secondly, when it's full, to tie it up like this to secure it over the top. And I'll show you a bit more on that shortly. Now, I've come fairly unprepared with what this was predominantly designed for, which is collecting and carrying firewood. So if you're out collecting firewood, you can lay this out, put the wood in the middle here, fill it right up. You can fit heaps of timber in there. Tie this up over the top to secure it if you like, and then you can just carry it with this handle here back to your campsite. Imagine that being much fuller. If it is quite full and a bit heavy, you can then just use these slings here to throw it over your shoulder and carry it to the campsite. Furthermore, if you want to secure this around the top when you're using these handles, you can just use a tie or a clip or something through these eyelets here just to keep that secured up over the top. And when you get back to your campsite, unload your timber and put it next to the campfire. And if it's raining, you can then use this cover to put over the top of your wood. You can peg it down in the corners here. This would just fit a standard peg through the corner there. These ones fit nicely over the top. Keeps the rain off of your firewood. So that's another use for the firewood carrier. And before I go into the other uses that I can see that are useful for this, I want to show you that it's not just a carrier for firewood, you can also carry other stuff. So let's say you're unloading your cart and moving to the campsite. I've got three decent sized camp chairs here. I can load these up in the middle of the sling here. That'll fit three of those. And if I fold this up over the top, the short handles still meet, and I can easily carry those three chairs from my car to the campsite without messing around with three sort of things hanging over my shoulder. I can tie this up. Once again, I'll demonstrate this. Tie this to secure it over the top if we don't want it falling down. So whenever I put that down now, these handles here are ready to go. It's not falling down to the ground, nice and easy to grab. Other uses, if I'm not using it for camp chairs, I can see that poles, because quite often poles can become a little bit awkward to carry, but I've got six steel poles here. Carrying them individually can get a little awkward. Put them in the sling there, lift this up. As long as you've got the weight distributed evenly, makes carrying the poles to your campsite nice and easy too, and you can fit tons more in there now. That lifts that up nice and easily. Even a large tent, there's been questions around weight rating for this. They haven't actually tested it, but this is going to be able to carry far more than your average person can lift. I've got here a large canvas style tent. This is going to be somewhere in the vicinity of about 20 to 25 kilos. If I lift that in the middle there, I can use these long straps to tie it over the top if I like, or these short straps do meet on top here, and I can lift that up, and that very easily carries that bag there. I know there's handles on the bag itself, but this just offers you another option. I can also use the shoulder strap here, lift that up and over my shoulder. So it's going to comfortably carry anything that you need from your car to your campsite, even the heavy items like your canvas tent. Now, we haven't touched on dimensions and weight, but it weighs about 450 grams. And when it's laid out flat like this, it's just under a meter in length and about half a meter in width here. So when I talk about other uses for the mat here, when it's laid flat here, becomes a ground cover to protect you from dust or dirt on the ground when you use it as a lunch mat, maybe to spread your tools on, maybe to lie on if you're working on your car. You could use it as a boot liner or even seat protector if you like. Set it up like this as a bit of a seat protector if you've gotten muddy or wet after a trip to the beach or you've had to get in the mud to dig your car out. If you were to stand it up, use the eyelets in the corners, set it up as a wind, rain, or a sun shelter or a sun break for in the window of your car or around a stove, or use it to close that gap in between your awning and your vehicle where the rain might come in. You can just sort of tie it up in place there for temporarily, just while the storm passes over. It's gonna keep the rain and the wind out. Once you're done carrying all your gear, you can even use this as a doormat in front of your tent. Use the eyelets to peg it down so you're not gonna trip over it. It can get as dirty as you want. You can just hose it off, give it a scrub. Make sure it's dry before you store it, and it's still gonna give you years and years of use carrying gear and giving the protection you need in your campsite. This is one of those items that has got 101 different uses in the campsite and can be a really valuable addition to your camp kit setup. You can check them out online at snowys.com.au, where you'll find them at our lowest prices every day. If you've got any questions or ideas on what else this can be used for, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all our latest and greatest information, or check out some other blacksmith products like this one down here.